Hi, welcome to Learning Monkey. I am Raghuveer. In this class, we do some practice programs in Python. In our Python playlist, we clearly discussed about how to improve our coding skills in Python. There we have discussed we have to follow three steps to improve our coding skills. What's the second step we discussed? We have to get the deeper understanding of the concepts of Python. These programs will help you in getting the deeper understanding of the concepts of Python. Our suggestion is to take the questions, try to solve it on your own, then check for the solutions. If you are taking more than 2 to 3 minutes to solve these questions, means you are not good in practice. You have to repeat, try to solve them, these questions again and again, this entire playlist, do it again and again till you get that better understanding. Now let's take the questions. First take the questions, then we will explain the solutions. This is our first question. What's the first question is, find the output of the given code. They have given some code and they are trying to you have to identify what's the output that is displayed by you, by this code. That is what you have to identify. Take this question. So coming to our second question, this is very, very important to understand. Please take how much time you want to understand. You take whatever the time you needed, but this is very, very important to understand. This gives you a good understanding about how to write the real-time programs. This is one of the real-time program. This is example will help you understand one of the real-time situation. This will provide you more intuition on coding. So do it again and again. Think about this question again and again till you get the clarity. What they are asking here is, a company is trying to conduct two competitions to their employees. They are trying to conduct two competitions. They have opened two portals for registration. So identify the code at line 1 in the given class below. So they have given the code and they have missing one line of code. We have to identify what that line of code. That is what you have to do. In here, get total registration in this method. They have missed one line, hash line 1. What's the code that needed to write here at this line? That is what we have to identify. So what's that line is, so that the get total registration method should give what it has to return. It has to return total number of participants registered for both the competition at any given point of time. If you call that function get total registration, it has to return the value total number of registrations done up to now in both the competitions. That is what it has to provided. Means you have to write a single statement, that is return statement. It has to provide total number of registrations done by both the competitions. That is what you have to provide. Take the question, try to do it on your own, then check for the solution. Okay, and the continuation is, you have to fill this line with a return statement. So coming to the solution part, try to understand the first one. What they are doing here, class surgeon class, for the constructor we are going little bit fast, because in our previous 5 examples we have practiced much. That's why we are going fast. They are taking the constructor. They are taking the constructor here. Constructor is taking the ID. Surgeon ID is taken from the constructor. Means whenever you created an object, it is taking the input as surgeon ID, and this is assigned to the instance variable, and they have written a method identify amount of method. What this method is doing, it is taking fee list, surgeon ID list. Two lists are available, surgeon ID list and fee list is available. Means surgeon IDs are available and their fee is available. 1008 fee is 18, 1004 fee is 15. That is what surgeon ID list and fee list is. So they are taking inputs of list. List is taken as the input and they are trying to identify something. What they are trying to identify something, that is what you have to identify. For index in range of length of surgeon ID list, means in the loop they are taking index values, index in range of length of surgeon ID list, means index taken from how many, length of surgeon ID list means how many are there, 1 2 3 4 5. So the loop will execute for 5 times. Each time it will take the index value. They are identifying if surgeon ID list of index is equal to self dot whatever the ID that you have provided, they are trying to identify that ID. If the ID is present, at what index the ID is present, that fee list, from the fee list in, they are taking that value and assigning to amount. Means what's this loop is doing? This loop is taking the fee amount for the given surgeon ID. So what they are doing in the next iteration, next loop, for index in range of length of surgeon ID list, if a fee list of index less than amount, whatever the amount for this surgeon ID, if the fee list, they are checking the fee list one by one, if the fee list amount is less than whatever the amount provided for this surgeon ID, means they are trying to take the amount, the surgeon fee amount that is less than the given surgeon ID list. If it is okay, then count is increasing, means they are counting how many surgeons that are less than the given surgeon ID list, whose fee amount is less than the given surgeon ID list. That is what they are trying to identify here, and returning the count, means this function is will return the value. Which value it will return? Count value. What's that count value? How many surgeons that are having fee amount less than the provided surgeon ID. That is what they are providing. And now coming to the solution is that surgeon ID, surgeon object is equal to surgeon of the ID provided here is 1004, and the output surgeon object dot identify amount, they are calling the function, they are calling the method as identify amount of, they are sending the fee list comma surgeon ID list. What it will return? It will return the count, count value, how many of them are having a lesser amount than the surgeon ID. So the count value is 3 here, the output will be 3. That is what they are providing. Coming to our second question, this is very, very important to understand. We already discussed about the question, so let's try to understand the code. They have given class competition. They are creating two competitions. That's why they have taken two class count variables. Count 1 is equal to, initially they assigned to 100. The count 2 is assigned to 500. So next they have initialization. The means whenever you create the object, object will call this constructor. What's this constructor is doing? Init of, it is taking the event name. Event name is taken as the input, and event name is assigned to the instance variable event name. Self dot registration ID is equal to none. So they are taking two instance variables, and the registration ID is taken as none. If self dot event name is equal to D, if the object is providing event name as D, see, self dot registration ID is equal to string DC plus str of self dot count to method of, it is calling a method, means the, here they are automatically generating the registration ID. Registration ID automatically, whenever you want to register, automatically it is generating the registration ID. For the next registration, it will generate new ID. For the next registration, it will generate new ID. See, this is the real time scenario. So that's why all the programs which are provided in this playlist, if you can solve this, if you understand these questions, you can easily write the coding. You can easily move to the third step. Means take the problem, write the code. Take the problem, write the code. That's why it is very important. How it is solving it? How it is solving? It is giving the new IDs each time. Self.count2 method of. What is count2 method of? It is a class method. Means it can access the class variables. What is class method and static method was discussed in our Python playlist. So it is, what this method is doing? See, let's check what this method is doing. Count2 method is increasing the count2 value. What is the count2 value? 500. 500 plus 1 means 501, but it is returning the previous count value. It will return the previous value but increase the count value. That is what count2 method is doing. The same way count1 method is increasing the count1 value and returning the previous value. That is what count1 and count2 methods are doing. So if the else if event name is equal to yes, it is generating the new ID based on event. SC plus new ID will be created. Whenever you create an object, if the event name is D, it will create a, the first ID is created as DC500. If you create one more object, if the event name is D as given as in that object, it will create a DC501 as the ID. Registration ID is given as DC501. If you create one more object based on D, it will create 502. If you create event name is equal to S, it will create a registration ID of SC100, SC101, SC102. Like that, it is assigning new registration IDs. Okay. And get total registration of these steps are not there. For understanding purpose, whatever we have done, it is correct or not, that in order to check that we have written this code, the bottom three lines, we have to write this line: return get total registrations of. It has to return number of registrations that are done at the given time. That is what it has to return. So whenever you have created an object, it is increasing the if the event is D, it is increasing count 2. If event is S, it is increasing count 1. So what's the initial values? 100 500. So if these values, count values, are increasing, whenever you created an object, the count values are increasing. Whenever you create an object, count values are increasing. So that's why we have to return computation dot underscore underscore count 2 minus 500. Why we are doing 500? The initial value is 500. If you create an object, count value increase 501. Count value increase 502. 502 minus 500. So how many registrations you got in second computation? 2 plus computation dot underscore underscore count 1 minus 100. Initially, what the value they have taken? 100. That's why if one object is created based on computation 1, count 1 will be increases. Computation 1, count 1 will be increases. So that's why we are doing minus of. This is the line we have to write in the given code. So here we have created two objects, computation of D, computation of S. So the output is 2. Output is 2. So that is what the, this is the line you have to write the code. Hope you understand the concept. Please do it again and again till you get the clarity. Okay. Hope you understand the concept. If you have any questions regarding the concept, please post your questions in the comment section below. Thanks for watching. If you haven't subscribed to our channel, please subscribe to our channel and press bell icon for the latest updates. Thank you.